can see, there's a lot of oil seeping out of the wood right now. It's about 86 degrees today, and it's only April 5th here in Georgia. Trying to decide what to do first. I'm going to try rubbing some boiled linseed oil on the stock and seeing if that'll bring out some of the old wood grain. So let's try rubbing some boiled linseed oil on the stock and we'll see if we can bring out some of the old wood grain. Apparently it's black right now with whatever it was that they put on it when they put it in storage is oxidized. It is so hot in the sun that I can barely stand to touch this gun stock. Well, it's really not wanting to do anything as far as get some of this grime off of there. It's going to take a lot more elbow grease than it did with the Murphy's Oil Soap, I believe. So let's try the Murphy's Oil Soap next in water. Maybe we'll try some Goop hand cleaner again. Again, these videos aren't this is how you should clean your gun. I've had a really good luck with the Murphy's Oil Soap. Beginning to think maybe the guys, they're just using a paint stripper and then refinishing their stocks may not have such a bad idea. Man, the black on this stock though, the black crud or whatever it is really not coming off at all. Taking a lot of elbow grease. You can see some beautiful wood grain underneath though. It's starting to get it. All right, let's try some Goop hand cleaner because I'm wanting this to go a little bit faster. As a last resort, I'll put the brake cleaner on it. Brake cleaner does work really well though. I'm sorry, I'm saying brake cleaner, brake fluid. Just plain old .3 brake fluid. See how this Goop hand cleaner works. Bluing on this receiver it's got a beautiful original bluing. The caulking indicator's worn, but the bluing that's left on the receiver is beautiful bluing. Okay, I'm gonna try some brake fluid up here on the four stock. I've already smeared that side with Goop. We'll try brake fluid right now up here. I'm gonna keep scrubbing at this. I'm gonna stop the video. I will scrub at this part right here with the brake fluid on it. See how quickly that works. And I have to say the brake fluid does work better than anything as far as getting this grime off. Goop hand cleaner comes in a good second. And I picked these items because they're items that you really, it won't be a necessity for you to wear protective gloves to use. So if you've got some heavy grime you want to scrub off, you can either use the .3 brake fluid or a goop hand cleaner. I am gonna stop filming now, and we'll pick up here in probably another hour or so. Slathered up with some more brake fluid. It eliminates some elbow grease. I was concerned that it would stain the wood, so I'll just wash the wood with a bucket of water with Murphy's oil soap and try to wash some of the brake fluid out of the wood later on. But in this heat, the brake fluid is just eating this grime through in a matter of minutes, and it's wiping right off. Got some cracks in here. One of them just snagged my wood. I've got a few minor stock repairs I'll have to do. I'll be ready to strip this down though much faster than I was with the Mark IV. I don't know if you can see it. See all the original blue left on the gun? As compared to the antique patina of the Mark IV I cleaned. I'd still be wearing my gloves today, but you know what? 86 degree weather, your gloves just trap the heat and you sweat so bad inside the gloves that there's no point in even wearing them. Your hands are raw by the time you're done. All right, I'm done scrubbing. Used mainly brake fluid on this to get this unmarked, untouched Mark II, this clean. A lot of original bluing left. Looks pretty nice, I'm very happy with it. I'm gonna start stripping it down. First thing I want to do is take the forearm off, forestock. We'll go ahead and start with the center band right here, center stock band. Let's see if we can't get it to move just a little bit. Maybe some of this brake fluid has gotten through this dirt. Kind of doubt it because it's dry under the head of this screw. Nope, it's not moving too readily. Try to jar it loose like we did yesterday.